I'll be damned. You did it.
That was quite a speech.
Lies, all of it, I'm afraid. Still, such words have carried us thus far.
And what of Pitcairn?
He's left Boston, as I said he would, and set up camp on Alter Hill. There's no good way to get at him. Not with that maelstrom rolling down below. I suppose you could circle around a bit, or wait for us to thin their ranks.
There is no time. I will have to chance a direct approach.
That's twice today you proposed the impossible.
I see no other choice.
Not because you're mad as a March hare, son.
I expect an apology on my return.
Now you die!
you do this?
To protect Adams and Hancock and those they serve. You meant to kill them.
Kill them? Are you mad? I wanted only to parley. There was so much to discuss, to explain. You've put an end to that now.
If you speak true, then I will carry your last words to them.
They must lay down their arms. They must stop this war.
Why them and not the Redcoats?
Do you not think we ask the same question of the British? These things take time. And it would have succeeded had you let me play my part.
Part of the puppeteer.
For better we hold the strings than another.
No, the strings should be severed. All should be free.
And we should live forever on castles in the sky. You wield your blade like a man, but your mouth like a child. And more will die now because of that.
Saho yonere ne o te nam da setakwe. Tini o ne yaho te na tam da setakwe.
Speak up on me like that. Why don't you just go out there and just help this chap retreat? Don't ever do that again, you hear me? God damn it!
General Putnam.
You lived.
The same cannot be said for Pitcairn.
Well done, I suppose. But it matters little now. I'm ordering a full retreat. We have lost too many in exchange for too little. If the Tories want this hill so badly, let them have it. Boston is the true prize.
We have a bigger problem.
What do you mean? This can't be right. It says they plan to murder Washington.
This guy could have done so much with so little if his feet weren't made of cement. Now that Connor is reaching the early days of the Revolutionary War, the Templars are beginning to up their game as well. John Pitcairn was Haytham's military mind, recruited from one of Braddock's encampments before the Connor takeover of the game, and now he's being sent back to work for the British in order to stop this quaint colonist rebellion. Lexington and Concord happened shortly before this assassination, whereupon Connor was introduced to local Patriot leader Israel Putnam, brash man and cigar enthusiast. Yes, seriously. Who immediately enlists Connor's help because he looked really cool, guys. Connor was then able to outwit both the cannon placements of Pitcairn's forces along with his barricades on the hill to sneak into his proper camp. Pitcairn is there, rerouting his men towards Bunker Hill to try and secure a victory after the fighting got really intense and brutal somehow. Apparently, Pitcairn recruited some real dunces on the team to put on guard patrol, since Connor was able to sneak around camp into some nearby trees and kill Pitcairn from atop a horse. This sneak mission is a bit tricky and difficult. It's a nice bit of challenge and shoddy design that'll give you at least 5 minutes worth on the game on the edge of your seat. Upon his death, Pitcairn laments the stupid assassin due to the idea that Pitcairn was actually fighting the Battle of Bunker Hill to get to the Patriot commanders and ask for a truce to the uprising before the war broke out. And the only question I have to this attempt to redeem his character is this. If you were such a brilliant commander, how did you not find time to meet with the rebels before Connor had all this other time to kill you in the middle of a revolutionary battle? Seems like you were being pretty lazy there. The Pitcairn assassination was good, not great. Trying to sneak around cannon fire is pretty hit and miss. Getting around Pitcairn's camp is an ass, and it doesn't even make sense how Connor got the distance to kill Pitcairn from a tree since he's sitting in the middle of a clearing, but whatever. It's not like Connor doesn't have 3 long-range weapons on him to do the job anyway. If this is Assassin's Creed 3 at its worst, then it's still a damned great game.